Today we start our long reading season known as Trinitytide or Ordinary Time. It is that long series of teachings about Jesus that Jesus gives about the nature of God and how it is that you have us live. Since Christmas, actually since Advent, we've had all sorts of short seasons and some long seasons where we have looked at different aspects of the spiritual life. We had Advent,
and the bank
by analogy with Jesus Christ. And so it is rewarding to those who Jesus is talking to and preaching to that they are not being invited, and they better not make excuses for why it is that they cannot come into relationship with Jesus Christ. So what does that have to do with us today? Well, I'm going to give you two ways in which that's true. First of all, like I said, congratulations. It came on the Sunday that this reading is being read. You've come to the banquet. This is the great feast that Jesus has prepared for us by giving us his own body. We talked about last week how we're invited to come forward as a sense of an altar call every time Jesus is offered to us in the sacrament. So it is, you've been invited to this great banquet as you are every Sunday. You came today. Good work. Thank God. But the reality is, like I said, is some people are traveling. And there are other people who've got a million excuses. I've got boxes to try out. I'm not sure I hear that very often, but it could happen. I've got a tea time. I've got a baby shower. I've got a little baseball game. You're guilty of all of those. Where's our priorities? We're invited. This is the most important thing in the world, that we worship Jesus every Sunday in his church, whether it be here or in another congregation where we're traveling. This is the most important thing. We don't want to prove ourselves unworthy of being invited to his banquet. But yet there's one more level that's just as important for us to look at as well. And that is that we are to be like the servant in the story. Because you know what? Our job now is to invite others to come into relationship with Jesus. We are fed and nourished in the sacrament, as we said last week, in order for us to be sent out into the world to share the good news of Jesus Christ. You were invited to this banquet today in order to be nourished, but there are empty seats here. And there are people out on the highways and the byways, the halt and the main, and everyday James and Joes who need to come into relationship with Jesus Christ. And you are bidden as a servant go out and to invite. I still think I have a good guest who actually showed up. Now I got a job. Now I've got a mission. This story isn't just about me being here on time and in the right place. But this story is also an invitation to us to be like that good servant and to go out and to bring others into relationship. By living his message, as simple as a conversation as, hey, you know, you ought to come to church with me. It's a great place. Good news is preached. There are wonderful people there. And I am sure that God has a plan for you. Let's go home and figure it out. It is an invitation like that, couched in prayer, your prayer and ours, that brings people into relationship. So you know what? The table's set. In a minute, the meal will be prepared. You're here for the great banquet. Come and be nourished. And then go out, because we'll be back here next week. Go out and invite others to join us. In the name of the Father, and of the Son.